Hi, my name is Mauricio, and welcome to another Cloudwards video review. Today, we're talking about IDrive, one of our favorite online backup services. It's a powerful backup solution, but it's also not without its issues. Before we start, let me just remind you to click the like and subscribe buttons if you get anything out of this review. If you enjoy our videos regularly and want to give something back, that's the best way to help us out and make this channel grow. Also, let me know in the comments which service you ended up choosing and why. IDrive is a cloud backup service. That's not exactly the same as a cloud storage service like sync.com or Google Drive, but there's a lot of overlap. Cloud storage gives you extra space to store files outside your home devices and lets you access those files from basically anywhere. Online backup, on the other hand, is about protecting your files from anything that might cause you to lose them. That means crashes or even cyber attacks like ransomware. Anything that makes you go, "Oh crap, I hope I save it," it automatically syncs with your computers to save versions of your files that you can recover if anything happens to the main ones. Most of the best cloud storage services offer backup features, but IDrive is primarily a cloud backup service that has added, well, some storage features and some synchronization and some things here and there on the corners. You can use IDrive through a desktop client on Mac and Windows or as a web app on any OS, including Linux. It's also got mobile apps for iOS and Android. IDrive syncs up with your hard drive to save copies of your files. If something gets deleted on your hard drive, it's still there on IDrive along with its previous versions. The mobile apps actually back up your mobile device. Lots of cloud backup services treat their mobile apps as basically just a remote control for the desktop client, but IDrive gets that people save important files solely on their phones. Let's get a bit deeper into how IDrive backup works. You can backup your information at any level, from individual files to folders to your entire hard drive at once. Backups happen on an hourly or daily cycle, but you can start one manually whenever you want. If you've got files smaller than 500 megabytes, you can have IDrive back them up continuously. IDrive Express is another awesome feature. If you've got a huge drive on the order of terabytes, you've probably wished you could back it up on a physical drive and mail it to your cloud service. And that's literally what IDrive Express is. Earlier, I mentioned IDrive has some cloud storage features. You can save files in folders that sync between devices, which don't count against the storage on your plan. So you've got essentially twice the storage space, if you will. All the different IDrive clients are user-friendly. On desktop and the web app, the features are grouped into simple tabs. Backup controls, basically what gets backed up. Restore lets you restore lost files, etc. The mobile app is more stripped down since it's mainly focused on protecting your photos and videos, well, on your phone. Okay, let's talk a little bit about pricing. IDrive has a free plan that lets you backup up to 5 gigabytes. You can get personal plans for 2 terabyte or 5 terabyte, but that are actually not very expensive. Depending on the current discounts, you'll only pay around $50 in the first year for 5 terabytes. You can only buy annually though, which makes it a bit more of an investment at first. If you're not sure about committing, the free plan is a great way to test the service out. Every plan backs up an unlimited amount of devices, and business plans let you bring unlimited users on board and also backup servers. The downside is no plan gives you unlimited storage. Some cloud backups do offer that, and we've linked them in the video description as well. The real drawback with IDrive is speed. Most users are going to be uploading gigabytes of data at a time. IDrive takes about 2.5 hours to upload a 3.5 gig mixed media folder and about 1 hour 15 minutes to download it. American users might see better speeds. For everyone else, it's rather on the slow side, I would say. Most people will face the decision if they should go with IDrive or Backblaze. Honestly, it's a tough one to answer because it really depends on your situation. Personally, I tend to recommend Backblaze to people who are not very tech savvy because it's just like set it and forget it, plus it offers unlimited online backup. iDrive, on the other hand, has much more customization options, so you can really drill down into the settings menu and configure your backups how you want them. If you have a lot of devices, then obviously go with iDrive, because you need to purchase additional Backblaze licenses if you intend to backup more than one computer. Unlimited backup, well, sounds great on paper, but do keep in mind that with Backblaze, you need to keep all of these drives and computers connected at least once every 30 days for the files to remain on Backblaze's servers. And that's pretty much it for our high-level review of iDrive. I hope I've been able to help you make a decision about whether it's the cloud storage you want. If you like this video, one more time, don't forget to hit like and subscribe so we can keep spreading it around. And thank you very much for watching. Hope to see you in my next video. Bye-bye.